Reverend Father Chandy Kalthur, Rector of Rohanian Seminary, Reverend Father Joseph Renard Martin, Reverend Father Thomas Kannani, my professor, Very Reverend Father George Nambali, and all the respected fathers, and dearly loved brothers, on this wonderful Sunday, it's a great privilege for me to witness to this wonderful day and the marvelous programs that you have put up here. From the very first, I would raise my grateful heart to the Almighty Lord, remembering the quotation from the Psalm that, "Rejoice with the Lord, all you righteous, and give thanks to the Lord with all your heart." The same feeling of the psalmist is in me, because I am back to my Atma Mater after so many years. And I know this privilege has fallen to me only because I was a student of this institute, the Board of Knowledge, the institute, the home which has created thousands of wonderful priests for the missionary work of the Lord, and it will continue to do its work as Mother Church keeps Rohanlea as the apple of her eyes. I wish all the success and all the very best for all the activities that are going on here in this great institute. As I stand here, as I was listening to the report prepared and presented by Brother Robin, within this limited span of months and days, you have managed to come together and have your 14 or 15 culture events, and all of you were participant, and got chance for at least 2 speeches, and many other items were read out here, and we got the chance to witness also a wonderful skit, the jock mixed dance, and many other, and all the speeches presented here with a lot of inspiration. The English speech on the opportunity, really it was wonderful. Hindi also I was asking Father, as the brother of third year, but I didn't know the brother is of first year only. The first year itself, if you are very smart, what will be when you are a priest? As it is well said by Saint Irenaeus, that God is glorified when man is fully alive. Yes, cultural events are the occasion where we show our true color, where we get a chance. As Father Venkatramanam was introducing me as an intelligent student, actually I am only average. As I was in my home, as a beginner, I was very good in learning in my primary classes, but coming to the middle session, I was below average. Somehow I managed to come out of 10th class and I joined the convent. Here in the Rohanlea and other higher studies, I was an average student. And I am standing here because my mother taught me also a lesson. If you are a loser, don't mind, but never miss the chance. Whenever we have small program in our parishes, whenever we have little competitions, my mother used to scold me, if not only to me, we are 3 children, and if any one of us misses the chance, mother used to scold, and she arranges it some. She studied only till 3rd standard, my mother, and even my father too. But they had the understanding that children should not miss the opportunity. As I witness this beautiful event, dear brothers, I wish to tell you also the same. During our formation period also, I have found some backbenches, some those who simply waste time, or I would say take things for so lightly and uses their time for time pass. But there is no moment for time pass. Every opportunity that comes to us to be utilized. And as I stand before you, I wish to share with you nothing, but once as I was traveling to Kerala, one of the priests of some diocese, he asked me a question when he came to know that I was a student of Ruhaniya. He asked me, "You religious man, why do you study philosophy? And what's the need of, and what did you gain after learning?" Actually, I was a student of Ruhaniya only because of the obedience to my superiors. I never wanted to be in teaching field. I wanted to be in nets. I wanted to escape from studies. But my superiors knew what is best for me, what is better. And I was here. And when the priest asked me in the train while we were traveling, when he asked, that was the moment I also thought, what did I gain? What is the use of learning philosophy? Then I gave an answer that which came very suddenly to my mind, that at least I learned to accept people and to understand that reality has different sides. There is different views of people. As you studied so many theories of the Plato, Socrates, so many other great philosophers, nothing is there with me now except some of the lessons I learned from the life of the great professors here. They were all very very compassionate and very helpful to us. Seven of us were there in the first batch who used to come to this Ruhaniya with difficulties and with a lot of fear. But when, as we started coming, the fathers were very cooperative, helpful, and we were afraid because, like you, the brothers who are now priests, they were very smart, very good, very intelligent people. To sit with them in the classrooms was something very horrible. So, horrible in the sense we could not cope up the way. In the beginning, we were very much afraid how to be with these brothers who are very, very much talented. But as the days went ahead, we understood they are also like us. And we had wonderful time. We had a wonderful time, and there were moments when we were in the university exam, Vikram University. Even sisters were leading also. Sisters were university rank holders also, even from our batch, my batchmate sister Deepa. And there was good competitions too. And I do share this, from all this I have learned one thing. The philosophical studies helped me to understand that there is beautiful thing in everyone, and you should know to everybody as they are. There is, as we have learned, the six blind men went to see the elephant. Everyone felt in different manner. They felt, they expressed, the elephant is like a tail or whatever, you know it. But everybody was one way or other way correct. So you know, we the sisters, we don't stay alone. We are in a community. And this particular study helped me to accept everyone as they are. A spirit of tolerantism, that is what I have gained. I, as Father Penatumantam invited me, I tried my level best, telling Father, I am not the person whom you are searching for. But to say the truth, I wish, I like the such cultural activities, to witness, to watch, all this I like. I remember the brother who was performing the first song, solo song. I have by you, the way you communicate to the society, the way you contribute to the society is really appreciated. You should keep continuing doing things wonderfully for the Lord. And we must learn one point only I want to tell again and again. Meanwhile, I request Sister Tessin, please come forward. As it is culture program conclusion, really we want to contribute. As said, Indonesians told that God is glorified when man is fully alive. We both see, not so much wonderfully like some of you, but we wish to share with you our talents. I request Sister to connect the track. We have prepared one song dedicated to Saint Joseph. In this year, dedicated to Saint Joseph, a song which is very well known to all of you, Saint Alphonsus song only. Kudamalu, that song na Kudamalu. That same songs Hindi we have prepared. We prepared it for some other purpose. And today morning on this, I thought let me share with you this one, this little effort of ours.
Share our talents.